Washington. I was born on February 22, 1732, in Virginia, USA. It was interesting growing up in my family because I had two older brothers. One was in the Army and I admired him. I want to tell you some stories about my childhood. The children in my school always chose me as a leader. I loved animals and especially my horse. And the last thing was that I loved surveying. When I was in school, I was an expert in mathematics. I was also very honest. When I grew up, I learned how to live in the wilderness, and that helped me become even a better leader. I also joined the Army, and my leadership skills helped me become the major of the Virginia Army. In 1754, the French would not let English settlers put their farms in the Ohio Valley. I was called there and became colonel. I was married with Martha Custis in 1759. We moved into a house in Mount Vernon. Tonight, Colonel Washington was called to war again. They wanted England to stop charging taxes. The colonies wanted England to stop charging taxes on them. England refused. So in 1775, a war started. The war lasted 8 years. The colonel, me, was now General George Washington. We won the war. Now I was the president. They needed a president because they were now the United States of America. They needed someone to lead. I'm sometimes also called the father of our country. I was president for 6 years and re-elected for 6 years for president 6 years again. I became famous because I was the first president of the United States of America and an excellent leader. Thank you for letting me tell you about my life. Here are some good listener questions for you. In which colony was I born? And who was I married with? For how much time was I elected and re-elected for president in all? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is John Fitzgerald Kennedy. I was born on May 29, 1917. It was interesting growing up in my family because I had 8 brothers and sisters. I'm going to tell you some stories about my childhood. When I was two, I got a very dangerous fever. I got better, but that gave me health problems for the rest of my life. When I was 14, I entered George School in Connecticut. I liked science and history courses and not so much spelling and math. I was after sports. I was often sick. And I liked to play jokes on my friends. By that time, when I was 19, I entered Harvard. In my last year, I wrote a book. I wrote a long paper called Why England's Left, that later became a book. Later, I wrote a book called Profiles in Courage that won the Pulitzer Prize. By the time that I was 15, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor. I joined the Navy, even though I had trouble with my job, with my back. Japan carded the boat that I was commanding. That was a PT boat. They cut it in half, and I saved my men from island to island in the Pacific. After the war, my father suggested, after the war ended, I came back home, and my father suggested me to throw me to try to get a spot in the House of Representatives. I wanted it, and I was in the Senate for 14 years. I liked what I was doing in the Senate, but I wanted to do more. In 1960, I declared that I wanted to be president. My rival was Richard Nixon. It was the first debate she won on TV. I won the election, but it was very tough. The election was inside 120,000 votes by the winner. The U.S. was passing through tough times. The Soviet Union wanted to put missiles on Cuba to shoot them at USA. I talked with the Soviet Union leader, make them stop. And it was during the Cold War that was present. In 1963, in that year, I visited Germany and Iceland. And on November 22, I was in a car without a roof, passing through Dallas. Lee Harvey Oswald, from the sixth floor to the Book Depository Building, Texas, had a rifle and shot me. At the hour I was dead, people cried when I died. I was famous for saving people when I joined the Navy and changing America. Thank you. And one of my quotes were, ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country. Here's some thank you for letting me tell you about my life. Here are some good listening questions. Did I join the Navy or the Air Force? What prize did I win for writing a book? And who killed me? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Anne Frank. I was born June 12, 1929 in Frankfurt, Germany. In Germany, there was a man named Hitler. He blamed innocent people for Germans' problems, but mostly on Jews. My family and I were Jewish, so we had to move to be safe. We moved to Amsterdam. In Amsterdam, I went to a school and felt safe. Later on 1939, World War II started. Hitler became the leader of many European places. Started to feel unsafe, so my dad decided to build a secret apartment. We lived there for 2 years. While I was hiding, I wrote in my diary, and I felt better when I wrote. One sad day, they found us. We were sent to the concentration camps. Me and my sister got sick there and died. My father survived. Someone gave him my diary. Now my diary is a famous book, and I am famous because I wrote during terrible time the story of my family. Here, thank you for listening about my life. Here are some good listener questions. What did I write? Where did I hide? Where did they take me? Thank you.
good morning.
Hello, my name is Leonardo da Vinci. I was born in Vinci in 1452. The name Vinci stands for from Vinci. It was interesting growing up as a child because I could draw everything I saw. I drew animals, plants, insects, myself, and other things. I moved to Florence. In Florence, in art class, I was better than my own teacher. So then, they taught me to draw full paintings. When I grew up, I promised to design some war machines, like tanks, leg choppers, and giant crossbows, and other things. But it was something very strange for me to do because I was a very gentle person who hated war. My best work was The Last Supper. The Last Supper was in a dining room used by the monks in the church. Parts of The Last Supper are hard to see because I made my own paint and the paint is chipping off. My most famous painting is the Mona Lisa. The Mona Lisa is technically the most famous painting in the whole wide world. Ever since I drew the Mona Lisa, people have been talking about the mysterious look that she has. I was one of the first artists to make my painting seem real in all ways. Including, I was an architect, sculptor, drawer, engineer, painter, and sculptor. I was a mathematician, musician, philosopher, discoverer, last years of my life in France, guest of the king. I died there in 1519. I had 10,000 pages in all my notebooks, and they are all throughout the world in other museums. Now I'm going to ask you 5 good listener questions. 1. In The Last Supper, how many apostles did Jesus have? 2. Tell me 2 things I drew when I was a child. 3. What did I promise to do that I did not like? 4. What does Da Vinci stand for? 5. Why is the Mona Lisa so famous? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Neil Armstrong. I was born on August 5, 1930, USA, Wapakoneta, Ohio. It was interesting growing up in my family because I had to move 13 times before I was 16. I want to tell you about my childhood. I became an Eagle Scout. Some miles away from my house, there was an airport. In school, I had flight lessons. I learned everything about flying, and I got my pilot's license before my driver's license. Then I became a sergeant in the Navy. Then I learned how to fly rockets and became an astronaut, because the president of the USA wanted somebody to go to the moon. In 1969, Buzz Aldrin, Mike Collins, and me got aboard the Saturn rocket. At 9 a.m., the big moment came. The Saturn's rocket motors lifted. Soon, the first set of engines started. Then it circled the world 2 times, and finally we got to the moon. Buzz and me got to a special spacecraft called the Lunar Lander, and Mike kept flying the Saturn rocket. A special computer alerted us that we had low fuel. Then I quickly got up, got out, and put my step on the moon, and I said, "That's one small step for the man, but one giant leap for mankind." Then we got back to the Lunar Lander, back to the Saturn rocket, and got to Earth safely, and I became famous and received many medals. I became famous because I was the first person to walk on the moon. Now some good listener questions. How many times did I move before I was 13? What were the famous words I said when I got to the moon? And which license did I get first, my pilot's or my driver's? I'm done. Thank you for listening.
I still don't get it.
Wow.
Hi, good morning. My name is Jane Goodall, and I was born on April 3rd, 1934, in England. It was interesting growing up with my family because we all loved animals. I want to tell you some stories about my childhood. When I was little, I saw an egg hatch. From that day on, I loved animals. When I was in school, I loved to draw and paint animals, especially monkeys, apes, and chimpanzees. I went to Tanzania. I went to Tanzania to study chimpanzees in Africa. I fell ill with malaria. I got very sick, but I was okay. Usually when people get malaria, they could die, but I was very lucky. Then I went to college. In college, they taught me that I should take care and defend animals as well, especially chimpanzees, because they are starting to be extinct. I had to do many speeches because people were cutting down trees to sell to laboratories and selling monkeys to the circus and as pets as well. In my speeches, I said that you should not kill or cut down trees. I travel the world teaching people how to protect animals and how Mother Nature works. I was very sad but glad that I helped. Thank you for listening to about my life. Now I have some good listener questions for you. When was I born? Where was I born? What animals did I work with? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Mother Teresa. I was born in 1910, Skopje, Macedonia. It was interesting growing up in my family because I was the youngest one in my family. When I was a little girl, I wanted to become a nun, because many people in India were too poor or sick to care for themselves, so I would try to help them. After nursing school, I returned to the streets of Kolkata. I began teaching children how to write with sticks in the dirt. Other young women heard about what I was doing. They came and offered their help. I had many people help me open free schools all over the city. People all over the world started giving me money, medicine, and equipment. I traveled all over the world and I met important people. Then I received the Nobel Peace Prize. This prize is one of the most important prizes you can ever get. I died on September 5, 1997. I'm remembered because because I helped lots of poor and sick people. I became famous because I was an exceptional nun. Thank you for letting me tell you about my life. Here are some good listener questions. Why did I want to become a nun? Why did I receive the Nobel Peace Prize? Did I marry or have children? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Jacques Stowe. I was born on June 11, 1910, in France. It was interesting growing up with my family because I have one brother, Perry Angelic Stowe. Let me tell you some stories about my childhood. I love the ocean. I wonder why rocks sank and why boats floated it. I always play near the water. I went to college studies, then I called Navy. When I was in the Coal Navy, I decided to study the sea. I went to the aquarium because I wanted to live underwater longer time. I found out people were contaminating the sea, so I made a movie to show people that were contaminating the sea and underwater creatures were getting affected. And I also planted the flippers. Thank you for listening about my life. Here's three questions. First, what did I invent? Second, when we were born? Third, how did I become famous? Thank you for listening about my life.
Bonjour! My name is Claude Monet. I was born in Paris, France on November 14, 1840. When I was 5 years old, my family moved to a place called Le Havre. It was next to the ocean. I enjoyed watching ships and fishes. Even when I was very young, people thought I was talented. I will draw cartoons of people and they will buy them. At 11, I went to an art school. My mother wanted me to become an artist, but my father wanted me to work at family store. When I was 16 years old, I met an artist named Eugene Bowden. He saw my paintings and thought I was talented. He thought a lot about painting, but the most important thing was that he wanted me to paint at outdoors. When I was older, I met and married a woman named Camille. We have a son named Jin. During this time, I worked with other artists like Pierre Auguste Renoir and Edouard Manet. Together, we started a new way of painting called Impressionism. We were able to show the effects of light and shadows using quick brush strokes and lots of colors. I spent the last 10 years of my life painting my beautiful water garden. These paintings are famous. Some examples are water lilies, panel of water lily decoration, and beneath the Grand Canal. In 1979, my wife Camille died. I remarried a woman named Alice. Several years later, Alice and my son Jin died as well. When I was 68 years old, I started to go blind. This didn't stop me from painting. I continued to paint until I died in 1926, at the age of 86. I have some questions from the audience. My mother wanted to become an artist because my mother wanted me to paint the natures. I paint the water lilies. My Eugene Bowden wanted me to paint outdoors, and and then I remarried a woman named Camille, and Camille died, and that's all.
Hello, good morning. My name is Rosa Parks, and I was born on February 4, 1913 in Tuskegee, Alabama. When I was an adult, one day I was in a bus, and suddenly the white section was filled up. So a white man was trying to take my seat away, and I said no, and they took me to jail for doing that. And that is my story of how I became famous. When I grew up, some important things happened in my life. One, I won the Congressional Medal of Freedom in 1999. I won the Presidential Medal of Freedom from President Clinton in 1996. I helped segregation end December 20, 1956. I am famous because I said no, and I stood up for black people to have equal rights. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. helped me start the bus boycott. That means black people will not ride bus for 1 year. Thank you for letting me tell you about my life. Here's some good listener questions for you. One, what's one of the big prizes I won? With who did I start the bus boycott? Why was I sent to jail? Thank you.
Hello, my name is Diane Fossey. I was born in San Francisco, California, USA, on January 16, 1932. When I was younger, my parents did not let me have pets. This made me sad because I loved animals. Here are some stories about my life. My dream was to go to Africa. My trip was to go to Africa. So I had saved a lot of money to go there. When I got there, I had to choose a man who could help me. I chose somebody that could speak English. His name was Simbagard. So then we went to a camp and we built it. Then we started to look for gorillas. We found some gorillas. So then we came back and I finally met the mountain gorillas in Africa. I saw my first baby gorilla. I named him Digit, and I knew him for 10 years. But one day, he died because he was trying to protect his family. I went to Africa to study the gorillas, and I died because hunters did not like what I was doing. And thank you for listening to my presentation.
Hello, good morning. My name is Fiacaro. I was born July 6, 1907 in a small town of Coyoacan, Mexico. When I was 6 years old, I became very sick. I had horrible pains in my legs. The doctors discovered it was called bolios. This damaged my nervous system. To make my foot stronger, my dad made sure I would play sports such as soccer, boxing, wrestling, and swimming. I also liked climbing trees and playing ball, which were unusual activities for girls at that time. In 1922, when I was 15 years old, I entered one of the best high schools in Mexico City. Only 35 out of 2,000 students were girls. I made new friends. I was even a member of a group called Cachuchas. We were known for our intelligence and for our mischief. On September 17, 1929, I was sitting in the back of a crowded bus when a train crashed into the city bus. I was seriously injured. A piece of rail went through my body. A handrail pierced me like a sword pierced through a white bull. My spine was broken. My right leg was twisted and crushed. My shoulder was twisted. And my pelvis was broken in three places. I was in the hospital for 8 months. My whole body was in a plastic cast. I was surrounded by wooden frames to keep me moving. While I was in the bed, I started painting. I started painting my family, my friends, and myself. During the summer in 1929, I made my first self-portrait for Alejandro Gomez, my high school love. Well, I was scared. He left to Europe without me. While I was recording, I made new friends. My new friends were followers of communism. Diego Rivera was a communist party. One day, I called Diego to come to see my artwork. He really liked it. He said it was one of his happiest days of his life. Soon I started painting more. As the years went by, me and Diego fought, but Diego never was tired of me. In 1929, I displayed 25 paintings to France. My body had to be removed. My legs had to be replaced. I like living in a stretch chair. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I have some listener questions. One, where was I born? Two, what was it called? How old was I when I got born? Three, who did I give my first self-portrait to? Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Abraham Nippon. I was born on February 12, 1809. In Kentucky. It was interesting growing up in my family because I had an older sister called Sally. And my mother died when I was 9 years old. I had a very nice stepmother after my mother died. I want to tell you some stories about my childhood. When I was 7 years old, my family moved farther west to Indiana. I walked 2 miles to school and back every day. I love books. I would walk miles to borrow one. I was tall, thin, and very strong. I built a flatboat once with two other men. In 1831, I became a lawyer. Then I ran for president. I was elected. At that time, there were more than 3 million slaves in the South. Voters in the South were not happy to have a president who hated slavery.
supporters in the South were not happy to have a president who hated slavery. In 1861, a shot was fired at Fort Sumter by Confederate soldiers. The Civil War began between the North and South states. During the war, I wrote the Emancipation Proclamation. I was re-elected president. The war ended, the North won. In 1863, the war ended, the North won. An evening of April 14, 1863, I was shot. John Wilkes Booth assassinated me. I became famous because I freed the slaves. People think I was the greatest president of the United States of America. Thank you for listening about my life. Here's some good listener questions. Why did the war start? Who did I free? How did I die?
Hello, good morning. My name is Oprah Winfrey and I was born on January 10, 1954 on my grandmother's farm, Mississippi. It was interesting growing up in my family because I was really poor. Now I want to tell you a few stories about my childhood. I had to live sometimes with my grandmother, sometimes with my mother, and finally with my father. I had to move a lot. When I was in kindergarten, I already knew how to read and write. I even wrote a letter asking my teacher to move me to first grade. She did. When I was in college, I had a job working at a TV news channel. Then another TV channel in Chicago invited me to compete with another person. I won the ratings. It was a big step in my career. My show was called The Oprah Winfrey Show. It had been on TV since 1984 and ended in 2010. Many people watched my show every day. I treat my guests like friends. What I am most proud of now is a school I started for girls in South Africa. It is called the Oprah Winfrey Leadership Academy for Girls. I want these girls to get a good education and learn to be assertive. As you can see, education is so important for me that I've given away $400 million of my money to help educate others. I've been assertive all my life, and I want to teach other people how to be assertive, too. Thank you for listening to my presentation. Now I have some good listener questions for you. What did I already know how to do in kindergarten? Where was the school I built for girls? How much of my money did I help educate others?
Good morning. My name is Amelia Earhart. I was born in Atchison, Kansas. I was born on July 24, 1897. When I was a little girl, girls weren't allowed to do so many things as boys. But my little sister and I were lucky. Our parents thought everybody should be treated the same. We could play soccer, tennis, and other sports with our other friends. I saw my first airplane at the Iowa State Fair when I was 11 years old. I saw a plane doing tricks in the air. As I watched the plane turn and dive, I got so excited and I began taking lessons. I learned how to fly and all kinds of weather. When I was 25, I got my pilot license. I became the greatest woman pilot in the world. In 1932, I flew across the Atlantic Ocean by myself. I was the first woman to do this. Then I decided to fly around the world with a man named Fred. For a month, everything went well, but then no one heard from us again. No one knows what happened to me. Some people think our plane crashed in the ocean, but I had never been forgotten. I was known as the first woman pilot in the world. My brave spirit and exciting adventures still inspires women and many people around the world. Thank you for listening to my present. Thank you for letting me tell you about my life. Here's some good listener questions. What ocean did I fly across to? What girls weren't allowed to do what my parents let me do? What was the name of the man I flew with?
Hello, good morning. My name is Pele. I was born on October 23, 1940 in Trecoracos, Brazil. When I was growing up, my family was very poor. In class, I said about soccer instead of paying attention to the teacher. I quit school to play soccer. I played soccer without shoes because I was very, very poor. One day during practice, somebody started calling me Pelé. The nickname stayed with me forever. Pelé means food in Portuguese. In other parts of the world, they were calling me other nicknames. In Italy, they call me Il Re, meaning the king. In France, they call me the Black Ore, the Black Tulip. And in Brazil, they call me Perola Negra, the Black Pearl. At 17 years old, I was the youngest player to compete in history. In a world championship, I won 3 of them with my team. At 21, I led my team to another world championship. In all, I played 1,363 games. I scored 1,281 goals. I became the greatest soccer player in the world. Thank you for listening about my life. Now I will ask you some good listener questions. Where was I born? How many goals did I score? What was my name in Italy?